I do want to cover this because this is a critical question. It comes up a whole lot. People that are looking at calcium scores versus CIMT, and that whole conundrum of, wait a minute, my calcium got worse, so I'm worse off, right? So, and we keep saying, no, we want that, we want soft plaque to calcify. This is the actual, this is an actual study that shows that. So these are two plaques, they're basically comparable. This one you can't see quite as well, because that's, which one's soft and which one's hard? Somebody in here knows. The right one is hard, that's calcium, that white stuff is calcium. I don't use those terms. The white is calcified. So if you look at it, you can actually, it's not just subjective, they actually quantify it using those little bubbles and some technology. Here's what happens. The guys with the calcified yet still did have a couple of events, but those were the guys that had soft plaque, those are the guys that had hard plaque. So that's why we keep saying, we want you here, and lifestyle will get you here. We don't want you there. Do you understand what this is? Life table analysis, it's the probability of having an event. Every time somebody in the study, in the population has an event, the population goes down one. So each one of these drops is an event, and this solid line is the people that had the soft plaque.
What is the, you say lifestyle would get you there. Does lifestyle account for most of those improvements, or is it lifestyle being managed mostly?
Well, that, I mean, we know that from some other studies. This study won't tell us that, but, you know, there have been studies where they compare medication to lifestyle head to head. Moderate lifestyle wins out every time. So there's nothing that I or any other doctor can do that will impact your health and future like you, like the decisions you make all day, every day, how much you sleep, how good your sleep is, how you protect that sleep, how you do the boring stuff that helps you sleep, how many carbs you eat, how what your BMI is, how heavy you are. That's called a Kaplan-Meier life table analysis. So what that is you got two populations. You got a study population. You got a study population that's got, they have clear plaque. Let's go back up. They have clear plaque. This is important for what we're doing today and for a major reason that most of you came here. The question again is calcified plaque really that much safer? Because all I hear is the higher my calcium score, the worse off I am. And what they did, this is a study where they took people and they measured, they classified them into two different areas. This is somebody with a calcified plaque. That's what it looks like on your IMT. You're not likely to see a whole bunch of other people's IMTs, but I can tell you, it's out there, it's clear. And we look for progression from this to this. This is soft plaque, that's calcified plaque. Any questions about that concept, that this is soft plaque, and that's...
The soft plaque is probably more dangerous, it sounds like.
Yep. And this is, and if you say, well, how do you know that you can get certain gradations? You do get certain gradations. We do have quantification systems for grading quantifying how much plaque there is. Now, so they took the two populations, 112 in the solid line echolucent. And is that confusing you, the term echolucent? Because it confused me. These are the guys that had
statins.
Soft plaque.
Oh, okay. But the top guys were the ones that were on statins? Or?
Not statins. They had hard plaque.
Oh.
This has gotten... And statins have impact this issue, but this has got nothing to do with whether you got statins. This has got to do with whether you've got soft or hard plaque. The guys with hard plaque, calcified plaque, did have some They had a couple of events early on, so, and which is what you'd expect. Actually lends some validity to what that these guys are telling the truth and not making something up. This is the 100, so this is what? 112, wait. And it's sort of like a double negative, and I keep getting confused on trying to use the term echolucent. I'm not going to try. These are the guys that had soft plaque. These are the guys that had a hard plaque, calcified plaque.
The guys that had the hard plaque, isn't it? I mean, can't we fairly assume that they had statins?
Well, you can assume even more so that they were probably doing some stuff in terms of their lifestyle. I mean, it's clear lifestyle has a bigger... A 30-pound weight loss, you can't match with any kind of statin. A 15, 20-pound weight loss, you can't match with any kind of statin. Fat mass in and of itself drives inflammation, drives softening of plaque. Yes, statins do impact it, there's no question. But is it all statin? No, I mean, that's part of the difference between what you'll get here versus what you'll get out in the standard community. They'll look very quickly for a whole bunch of reasons to put you on statin that I wouldn't put you on a statin for. The Louisville event was an incredible success. Many people didn't know that that was our first attempt to coordinate the whole thing ourselves. And it was better than we had hoped. A lot of focus and people saying, you know what, I know that we can deal with this together as a group. There are other people that I'm meeting here at this event that are doing the same things I'm doing and with success. I don't have to be a doctor to know all this stuff. We are going to go ahead and have another one on February 28th in the Hyatt Regency Grand Cypress in Orlando.